Hello everyone, I'm Pacific the Casual Gamer, and welcome back to another video on Oblivion. And it's kind of ironic because I'm making this Oblivion video, and I'm playing Battlefield 5 just while I'm recording this. This is why I don't have the camera on, because, well, I can't look at the camera while I'm trying to kill people in Battlefield 5. So, today, I want to talk about my favorite spells in Oblivion, because, you know, as much as I like to say that, you know, the magic is bad in Oblivion, or, you know, it's just kind of dumb the way they did magic, there's still some really cool spells. You know, and the first one I want to talk about is the spell for telekinesis. I think telekinesis is an underrated kind of magic spell because it's there, it's gimmicky for sure. Very, very, very gimmicky. But, on the other hand, it can be very useful. So if you do something like, say, you really want to steal an item and you just suck at sneaking around people, right? It compensates for your sneak skill because at that point, if you have a decent range telekinesis spell, you don't really, honestly, you don't need to even get close to the item, right? You can just sneak around and just cast the telekinesis spell, take the item, right? You don't need to sneak around anyone, you don't need to do anything like that. Whereas without telekinesis, you may have to do some sneaking, you know, get a bit closer. So I think I like the spells, you know, I like unconventional type of spells in my video games, you know, like every time I bring up magic, I'm like levitation. I like levitation. Levitation's fun, you know, fun concept to do in a video game. It's just float around, you know? Another spell I really like is paralysis. I think it's a very underrated spell. You know, a lot of people, especially me when I first started playing Oblivion, and even to like a year ago, 6 months ago, I underestimated the power of paralysis because, man, just taking an enemy and stopping them from moving, right, is very, very beneficial. Because if you stop someone from moving, they can't block your attacks, they can't run away, they can't heal, you know? Think of like the first, like I'm just gonna use an example. If you're fighting an enemy, and the enemy's a freaking tank and heals himself at the same time, and you're fighting, like, sometimes Spriggans are that way. I don't know, I haven't really tried to cast paralysis on Spriggans, so I don't know if they're paralysis resistant or not. But, you know, you cast that paralysis on an enemy like a Spriggan, where you know that they're a tanky sometimes, and you know that they're gonna heal themselves, they don't get to heal themselves. They don't get to conjure up the bear, you know? So, I think it's very cool, the concept of just stopping entire combats with one guy, you know. I think if there's an area effect paralysis spell, I think it would totally be way too overpowered and definitely broken for Oblivion. And, you know, another spell I really like is, I like fortifying skills, you know, make yourself jump higher, do more damage. I like that, you know, there's kind of like a spell you can cast where you cast, you learn your restoration, and then you spend some magic points buffing your sword, right? Like, I think, especially people who really just want to play Oblivion, you know, sometimes when I play Oblivion, I don't want to cast 5,000 spells in the middle of combat. I just don't, you know? I don't want to go, oh, protect, and this and that and the other, you know? And I think that, you know, for the casual person, a good alternative is instead of having to cast every type of spell, just like buff strength, or a buff blade, or a buff marksman, you know? Like that. I think that I really, really do. I like those spells a lot. I really do like those spells. Just the fortify, you know, even if it's 10 seconds, 15 seconds. I mean, heck, even I have a character that I did a fortify fatigue on. I really like it. And there's a lot of spells that I really, really just don't care for. Like all the different protects and stuff, I don't really, you know, like. Absorb health is pretty cool. I think it's a cool spell. Absorb health. I like how absorb health is usually, I like it because it's usually less powerful than, say, the same amount of cost of magic to restore your health, right? So 10 points of absorb health is more expensive than restore. But it seems like a lot, and I really, really like that. That's what I like about absorb health. And I think it's cool that, if, you know, if a character needs health, that if they're good at restoration, you have that option of, like, all right, I'm gonna heal myself, but instead of just healing myself all the way, I'm going to sit here and be like, you know, okay, I'm going to take the enemy and damage them a little bit more. I like that you can do that. And there's really one other spell that I don't like a lot of these spells. Well, two other spells. Invisibility, because invisibility is really cool. You know, it's just really cool to go invisible and help you sneak around. I think it's a pretty cool spell. I don't like Chameleon. I think Chameleon's way too either underpowered or overpowered. Like, Chameleon, you can be invisible, people still see you. Pretty stupid, I don't like that. There's also Chameleon where it just makes you OP. And I don't like not seeing myself, but what I do like is the invisibility spells. Because I like how if you cast an invisibility spell, right? Say you just cast invisibility, the next thing you do is it costs you that invisibility. So I like that there's like a trade-off there, you know? I like that there's a balancing aspect to it and you can figure it out. And I like that it makes illusion valuable because, I mean, let's be honest. Frenzies, rages, all that stuff, you can't see enemy levels, so it's really hard to determine when to use those spells, so they feel kind of chancy. And if you don't, if you can't tell an enemy's level and you use it and it doesn't affect them, definitely feels wasted. The last spell set, that I really like is conjuration. I like conjuring stuff up. It's nice to not fight alone in Oblivion. You know, Oblivion's very much you are the guy or the gal who goes and like raids the caves. That's all you. And I like that there can also be that aspect of, you know, you have a buddy, you know, a skeleton buddy, a Diedrich buddy that fights stuff. And I also like the implications of sneak attacks and how you can use it to distract and kind of give yourself breathing room. It goes along with paralysis, where I like that you can use paralysis to your advantage to kind of stop fights if you time it well. Same with conjuration, because I've had times where conjuration doesn't do anything, or it's just like, why did I waste all this magic doing nothing? And I've also had times where conjuration stops a fight completely and I can be a little bit more of a tank. So that's really it for this video, guys. It's just a video on my favorite spells. Nothing too much, nothing too bad, just the spells I like. Conjuring stuff, crazy abilities, absorb health, which I think is either overrated or underrated. Very hard to figure out, quote, perfect balancing for it and how good it actually is in the meta. And you know what? That's that. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, feel free to leave a comment. Subscribe for more videos on Oblivion. I'm Pacific the Casual Gamer. I suck just as bad as you do at video games. And I will see you in the next episode, stream, vlog, or Instagram post of whatever I decide to make.